In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. I invite you to stand for the penitential rite, and I also ask you to wear masks in the chapel with the increasing numbers of COVID cases in our parish. We gather here this afternoon to pray for the happy repose of Ricky McNally and to give thanks to God for his life here on this earth, that we might celebrate Requiem Mass in a worthy fashion. We pause for a moment to call to mind those times in our lives when we have failed to show love. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Ricky, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. I invite you now to be seated for the scripture readings, which will be read for us this afternoon by Damien and Jim.
First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord will destroy death forever. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek, and he will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, see this our God in whom we hope for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit.
Lord,
response.
Shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With these you give me comfort.
Lord,
response.
Lord, shepherd,
you have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Response.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. For us our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Saviour we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will transfigure these wretched bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. He will do that by the same power with which he can subdue the whole universe. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. If you'd like to be seated for a moment. In our Catholic tradition, there are a lot of symbols and sacramentals used at every Requiem Mass, which highlight the sanctity of this moment, the sacredness of the Catholic funeral liturgy. These are far from being empty symbols, but rather symbols which are rich with meaning and which are meant to remind us all of certain realities. And I thought it important to avail of this opportunity this afternoon to say a few words about these symbols and sacramentals, to explain what they mean so that they don't end up appearing like some Catholic voodoo. For example, I received Ricky's mortal remains at the door of the chapel this afternoon, and as I received his mortal remains, I sprinkled them with holy water to remind us of Ricky's baptism when he was baptized into the death and into the resurrection of Christ. Dermot and Neil have placed the white pall over Ricky's coffin, again, to remind us that through the sacrament of baptism, Ricky became a new creation, and also to remind us of the white garment he was wearing on the day he was baptized in this parish. The paschal candle has also been lit today, as it was on the day of Ricky's baptism on the 7th of March, 1981, when he was brought to the chapel to be baptized. And then when we come to the final commendation at the end of Mass this afternoon, I will again sprinkle Ricky's mortal remains with holy water to remind us once again of our baptism, and I will then incense his mortal remains with the thurible to remind all of us gathered here in St. John the Baptist Church this afternoon that Ricky's body was once the temple of the Holy Spirit. And as the smoke from the incense billows out of the thurible and rises upwards, that will reflect all of our prayers for Ricky and for his loved ones rising up into the eternal presence of God. Death is the great leveller. I think it's one of the great beauties of every Catholic Requiem Mass that all of those who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, receive the same funeral liturgy, with the same symbols and sacramentals being used as we pray for their eternal repose and as we give thanks to God for their lives and as we honour their mortal remains, which, as I just mentioned, were once the temple of the Holy Spirit. Pope or parishioner, king or citizen, wealthy or destitute, in the Catholic tradition, we all receive the same funeral liturgy. We all come before God one day with open hands, with what we have achieved, with what we have done, with the lives that we have touched. One of three children born to Carol and the late Richard McNally, Ricky was born on the 6th of January 1981, the solemnity of the Epiphany, that day which recalls the visit of the kings from the East with their gifts to the newborn Saviour Jesus Christ. And I have been told by his loved ones that despite, or maybe even because of the disabilities with which Ricky was born, he was to prove himself a gift to those who knew him. He was brought to the chapel here to be baptized by Father John Bradley, who was then serving as a curate in our parish, to be baptized on the 7th of March 1981. Having been baptized into the Catholic faith in infancy, Ricky received a really supreme honor and privilege when he made, or when he received, his first Holy Communion from Cardinal Thomas O'Fee at St. Bernadette's altar in Lourdes in the south of France in May 1988. And Ricky received the sacrament of confirmation from Bishop Francis Brooks, the late Bishop of the Diocese of Dromore, on the 26th of March 1992, the day after the Feast of the Annunciation, when he chose at his confirmation ceremony the name Paul, which may explain why we chose that second reading this afternoon from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians. Following education in Fleming Fulton School in Belfast, Ricky got civilly married to Kendra on the 17th of November 2004, and also adopted her two children, Finlay and Aidan, who I'm told he regarded as his own. And Kendra has asked me to acknowledge this afternoon that Ricky was a perfect husband, father, son, and son-in-law. At the time of her death, I like to think and to highlight that family members can be consoled by their memories of their loved one who has gone to God. The human memory is a truly wonderful thing, for at will we can recall incidents and events from the past that make us realize just how special a person Ricky McNally was. Ricky's loved ones will remember his love of horse racing, the Green Bay Packers, the trip to Wembley Stadium to see the Jets and the Dolphins playing. You'll also remember those trips to Paris, the United States of America, and London, which Ricky loved, never allowing muscular dystrophy or his wheelchair to hold him back. The wonderful thing about the human memory is that how you remember Ricky, be that as your husband, your son, your father, your brother, your brother-in-law, your mate, is the way he now is in the eternal present of God's presence. Yes, it is true to say that for Ricky McNally, time as we know it has stopped, for his existence is now on a new shore in closer communion with God. And that gospel passage from St. John, which we heard this afternoon, it has a particular resonance for me because it was the same gospel passage used at my own father's funeral mass in 2002. And in that gospel, I think Jesus Christ offers us all great consolation and hope when he says at the Last Supper, the day before his own death and crucifixion, there are many rooms in my Father's house. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. This afternoon, that is our prayer, hope and conviction, that the risen Christ has indeed prepared a place for Ricky in his Father's house for all eternity. So as we escort Ricky by our prayers towards his final destination in heaven, we thank God for his constant presence with him in life and in death, and we pray for the wisdom to understand something of what God has prepared for those who love him. And we commend the soul of Ricky McNally into the loving hands of his Creator. To Ricky's wife, Kendra, his adopted children, Finlay and Aidan, his mum, Carol, and his brother, Dwyer, I offer my sympathies and condolences and those of my colleague, Father Clark, and the sympathies and condolences of the parishioners of the parish of Drumcree. And I just want to end with a little prayer that was given to me on the day of my own father's funeral, a prayer by St. Ephrem the Syrian. O Lord, you gave him to us to be our joy and consolation. You have taken him away from us. We give him back to you without a murmur, though our hearts are wrung with sorrow. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. I invite you now to stand for the prayers of the faithful. If we trust in God and have as our top priority to live a life pleasing to him, he will take care of us in life and in death. Let us now pray with confidence to our Heavenly Father for our various needs and intentions. That Christ, the Good Shepherd, may look with love on all those who mourn Ricky's passing from this world and bring them consolation in their loss. Lord, hear us. For all those who looked after and cared for Ricky, we pray that their generosity may be rewarded with abundant blessings. Lord, hear us. For all who are poorly in mind, body, or soul, that through the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes, they may receive every encouragement and strength and the grace of perseverance to carry their cross of poor health. Lord, hear us. For all those who are still suffering the consequences of the coronavirus pandemic, that God the Father may grant healing to those who are sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all the many victims who have died. Lord, hear us. We also pray in a very special way this afternoon for peace. For peace in our hearts, peace in our speech, peace in all our homes, peace throughout the world, and especially for peace in Ukraine. Lord, hear us. For all the faithful departed, especially those who were dear and very special to us. This afternoon, we remember especially Ricky, and also deceased members of the McNally family, remembering especially Ricky's late father Richard and his late sister Jardine. And we pray that they and all our deceased loved ones, freed from every shadow of death may take their place in the new creation where all tears are wiped away. Lord, hear us. Let us pray. God, our Father, may everything we do begin with your inspiration, continue with your help, and reach perfection under your guidance, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Imagine now to be seated for the preparation of the gifts. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hand and the praise of his name for the good of all his holy church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Ricky, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to stand for the preface. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. I now invite you to kneel for the Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his assistant bishop, Sean, our retired bishop, all the clergy, all the religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant, Ricky, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. Amen. And so we stand and pray together in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us
peace. I invite you to kneel at this point of the Mass. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say, the word of my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion, if you follow Francis's directions, I'll be distributing to this side of the chapel first. If you come up by the main aisle and go back to your seat by the side aisle, having completed that, I'll then transfer to this side of the chapel. Again, come up by the main aisle and go back by the side aisle to keep everybody safe. And then lastly, I will distribute to this side of the chapel.
Watch the sunrise, lighting the sky, casting its shadows near. And on this morning, bright though it be, I feel those shadows near.
O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacred heart of Jesus, immaculate heart of Mary, and for protection today, O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits thee here, ever this day be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule and guide. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul, and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us stand and pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Ricky may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Ricky. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet Ricky again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In silence, we now pray for Ricky's eternal repose and also for the consolation of all his loved ones. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive the soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive the soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Let us pray. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of your servant, Ricky. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant him everlasting peace through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us now take Ricky to his place of rest. And I would ask you to please observe social distancing in the cemetery.